I'm Healy, and this is Bedford Eats. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to make a triple chocolate overload cake. Let's get started. First off, you're going to want to make your favorite chocolate cake recipe into 3 6-inch round cups. I will put my cake recipe down in the description box below, but feel free to use whatever you want. Make sure your cakes are fully cooled before we get started. We are going to move on to our ganache, which is what we are going to put in between our cake layers. So what I have here is a small to medium saucepan, 200 grams of semi-sweet chocolate, 300 milliliters of heavy whipping cream, and a wooden spoon. So what we're going to do is turn on the oven to a medium-low, pour in our heavy whipping cream, and now we're going to let this come to a simmer. Alright, so as you can see, our cream is at a simmer, so we're just going to turn off the heat, remove it from the heat, and now with our pan off the heat source, we're going to add in our chocolate. Now the heat from the cream as well as from the pan will be plenty to melt this chocolate, and you're just basically going to stir it, constantly allowing it to melt until the ganache has become uniform. And then you are going to get a beautiful, uniform, rich looking ganache. Now we're going to also allow this to chill for a little while. Alrighty, now we are going to prepare our cakes for decorating. What you're going to need are your cakes, of course, a spatula, and a serrated knife. So first we're going to remove our cakes from their pans by just taking our spatula and running it all the way around the edge of the pan. Now we're just going to repeat the same step with our other two cakes. Okay, now that we have all three of our cakes out of their pans, we are going to level them. This is really vital when you're making a layered cake so that your cake is level and it's not tilting everywhere. So all you're going to do is take your cake and your serrated knife and find the lowest point in your cake, which is generally I'm going to go ahead and finish leveling my cakes and I'll be right back. Alright, everything is done and ready to put together. So, first of all, we have our ganache, which has cooled in the freezer actually for about 45 minutes. And I just put mine in the freezer because that way it chills more quickly. And you can feel free to just leave it in the fridge overnight or something like that. Here I have some chocolate bars with crisp rice in it. Some milk chocolate chips. Of course, our cake. I've got parchment paper here. I have a decorated turntable. You don't have to use this. I personally like using this, honestly, for this cake. It's not super essential, as well as your spatula. Okay, so let's get started. To start, I'm just gonna take a little bit of ganache and put it on our turntable. Thank you. we go.